Well, here's one for all the small car lovers in the world. So this is a resin version of a K-Class truck. And in particular, it's, I guess, based off of the Hoonigan. So Hoonigan.com, they have several videos on this project of theirs where they're taking a Suzuki Carry and putting a rotary engine into it, and it has a Pandem body kit and stuff. I haven't had time to watch these movies, so if anyone wants to comment on the highlights of that, please do. I also looked up the cost of this Pandem body kit. It's around $3,000 for those parts there. I guess that doesn't seem so bad because you are getting a lot of stuff. All right, let's get over here. We'll compare it to those photos. So the Suzuki Carry dates back to 1961 and has been going through 11 generations of sales. But this would be the ninth generation. And in particular, I think they're representing a 1995 because it has amber turn signals. So I don't really want to ruin this box. Has 660 cc's, as all K-Class trucks of modern times have to have. That's the limit. Couldn't figure out the power. I would just assume it's around 60 horsepower, though. Okay, there's no licensing. I'm not sure how YM Model stays in business, because I don't think they make any licensed models, but they've been around for a few years. Look at this. We got some extra yellow headlights or something. That's nice. Some extra parts. Alright, so. Now, what's interesting also about this is it's a front mid-rear layout, meaning the engine is actually in front of the rear axle. Somewhere around there, I guess. So that's kind of like sports car like, except for all your weight is up over here. This must be a really strange truck to drive, the handling of it. But anyways, let's see. So this one has clear, granted this is modified, I don't know. This could be an older ninth generation one. Wikipedia says in 95 they went to orange turn signals. And I'm not sure if this is a Photoshop of the gray. I didn't watch the Hoonigan videos, but it's got these four spoke wheels. This one has four spoke wheels. Sorry, let me hit focus now on the model. That's as good as I can focus it. All right, let's get into this thing. Get this bag out of the way. Alright, so reset the workplace here a little bit. So we have the photo etched metal thing here. That's an odd number. There's 570 of this particular color. Why they chose 570, I don't know. But I like that tells you what it is. D12, I didn't see that anywhere on the net though. Oh, maybe the. No, I'm looking at Wikipedia. It has nothing to do with the chassis code. So please leave a comment, someone. What does D12 mean? Is that something set by Hoonigan? Or is that something to do with the Suzuki Carry? Alright. So this base has this carbon fiber graphic, and I think it's just a sticker. Just looking at the thickness of it. I'm pretty sure it's just like a carbon sticker. Well, what I don't like is I think it's going to peel off. You know, it doesn't even look like it's applied very well. So, look. Well, alright, this is also very shiny. Let's get into this view here. So we got the tires and these wheels here. So the tires are nicely rounded. They seem okay. Looks like the Toyo tires is a decal. Now those wheels don't match the wheels that are on the Hoonigan website there, or the photo I pulled up at the end. So I'm not sure if these things exist in the real world. Maybe they do. I've never seen these wheels myself though. So please leave a comment again if anyone knows if these are real wheels in the real world or if these are just a fantasy casting. There's four lug nuts. There is a center cap. Let's get the flashlight. It looks like there might be that round thing. I don't know if that's a drum brake. It does say in this generation they switched from drum brakes to disc brakes, but sometime during this generation. So maybe this is like the very first of the ninth generation, and it has drum brakes front and rear. Because I don't see any disc brakes, right? Or do you? I don't see any. But YM models would usually have disc brakes. Of course, these are really small. I do see that front tire is compressed quite a bit, so I'm going to have to release some tension, and hopefully that'll help straighten it out. But I find... Oh, no, it's not. Look at this. This is weird how they set up the screws. They're side by side. Well, I guess I'll release it anyways. Just enough so it doesn't... I want it loose enough. Oh, wow. It definitely removed tension. Hold on. Let me show you. So look at the back tire. See? Look at that. It was like that. But now, it's like that. Wow. That, look at that. I mean, the plastic is cracked. So, bad tensioning at the factory. Let's see about this side. Yep, that definitely loosened up. As long as it doesn't wobble. It's still not wobbling. Alright, well... I think it actually helped. I don't think the front tire is crushed anymore. Maybe not. No, it still looks gappy right about there. Right? That looks gappy. Alright, well, continuing on, I can't do much about that. The body itself is this metallic green. What I'm trying to wonder is, is it a photo shift? I don't think it's shifting colors. I think it's just a metallic green. Okay. And then as usual, with a lot of brands, and in particular these resin ones, decals. I was actually, this model, this release, I think there was a white version and maybe like a Gulf livery version. And I honestly don't like any of them. I was waiting for them to come out with a second wave with just a plain color, but it's never happened. So that's why I went and bought this one. It's I at least like military vehicles, so this looks like, you know, a graphic from like a World War II fighter plane. So, but yeah, with my luck, they're gonna just come out with what I want next month. But oh well. Okay, not a fan of decals, of course, because there's gonna be air pockets. They also look wrinkly. They also look, yeah, it looks like orange peel, right? I could definitely understand a decal here on the windows, but down here, it just looks ugly. You know, this paint is so smooth, and then you just have this wrinkliness. And then very often, like here, you're gonna have air pockets in there, and this thing is gonna crack and stuff like that. All right, the lock mechanism is nicely molded. Recesses for the hand, this thing handle is sticking out a little bit. Some grooves in the door, nice tight gaps here. The windows are super thin plastic. You can really see me bend the plastic. It's kind of crazy. And then there's a piece of painted metal, I assume, for the window molding outside. The mirrors are probably rigid. Yeah, they're rigid. And then they have a shiny reflective sticker. You can really see the reflection of the door in that side mirror. Those windows are very clear. You can see right through to the other side. All right, let's go around more to the bottom and the back. The latches, I'm pretty sure this is a hinge, and this whole thing folds down so it can become like a flatbed. Or maybe not, because it'll scrape the wheels. Or maybe the regular one can, I'm not sure. But on a wide body kit one, it's just gonna obviously scratch that up. All right, the sponsorship there. The bed is pretty plain. I'm sure that's the way it is on the real truck. There's some corrugation in the back of the cabin. And then we have this little plastic, like, roll hoop or something like that. And then the thin plastic window with the metal, black metal molding. There's a little roof rack. It looks like it's literally going into the top part of the casting. Some reinforcement ribs up there. Yeah, that's interesting. Like floating in the front, but sitting on the back. Actually, maybe it's a little crooked. Yeah, well, can't do much about it. Alright, so the windshield, again, super thin plastic with the black molding. You can see a little bit of glue, though, over here behind that molding. The wiper blades, photo etched metal, painted black, and Are they bent? Perpendicular. Yes, they are perpendicular to the windscreen, so that's good. This side mirror is a little bit crooked. It's pointed too far down. Or maybe that's intentional. I don't think it is. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's glued very well here, right? Here it's much tighter. But I'm not going to mess with it. Alright, so this one has yellow headlights, and I like that it has, you know, the conical light bucket back there, and it looks like a light bulb in the middle. But the surface I'm touching is very far away from the back of that cone. So I don't know, I have a suspicion I'm touching yellow resin. I have a feeling they filled in the cone with resin. Because how else would they do this without air pockets? Please leave a comment if you have any theories. Alright, there's a little bit of black going around this. I don't know if that's an air gap or what. I can't tell if it's paint or what. I can't zoom in any further. This is 4x magnification. I can't tell. It looks like this is a chrome piece of plastic for the bezel, and that's part of this turn signal as well. And they just have transparent orange for the turn signal. I don't know. I don't know if that's good or bad. I mean, it's seamless with this round bezel like the real car. But I'm just used to having plastic turn signals by YM model. There's some bumps here for the wiper ejector, more panel gaps. And then here we have clear plastic and some silver behind these fog lights. But no texture from what I can see. I think it's just a flat surface. I think it would have been cool if they maybe put some striations back there to make it look more like a Fresnel's lensing. See these intakes, they're kind of going in there but not through. This one's pretty shallow though. This one's shallow as well. These are shallow. It would be nice if these, maybe some of them went through. They look like they do on the real truck, at least this one. I don't know about this. This one doesn't show up on that front image. Okay, well, we got a really thin chin spoiler. I'm assuming that's a piece of metal because it's so thin. And then we have two chromed or stainless pieces of metal holding that in place. And that does look accurate to the gray photograph I pulled up. Alright, this side here looks like a mirror of the other side. No fuel filler. Okay, tires look... yeah, they look okay. Now that the tension is gone. So the rear here, we do have... let's look at this rear turn signal assembly. I guess that has to be clear plastic, right? Look at the thickness of it. And the light bouncing around in there, so I think it's, yeah, clear plastic with some paint on the back side. And you can clearly see red and orange. But what is going on with this here? What is that? Is that the exhaust tip? I don't know. It looks like it might be a pipe. But the end of it is so poorly finished. It doesn't look like a tube. Right? I don't think that's good. It doesn't look like an exhaust to me. But what else would it be? I mean, it's clearly a tube. I don't know if there's a... what's going on? I think there's like... this painter stuck to that thing. I feel like it was probably glued to this surface here, and it broke loose, and that's what this thing I'm touching is. Extra glue. Yeah, that's not good. Probably shipping. I don't think it was YM's fault. It's just, you know, the force of shipping. Yeah, look at this. You'll see... hold on, my pick is... this is all, you know, flat. Here, it's missing a chunk because this exhaust is supposed to be resting in there. And it's interesting that it's moving this wheel at the same time. I'm not sure why this wheel and that exhaust tip are tied together, but they are. You know what? Maybe that's why his tension's so far down. Because, let me push this down. See? So that's kind of a weird design. You know, how they would have that exhaust tip attached to something relative to the rear axle. It's very strange. You can see underneath a little bit. It looks like there's a tiny indication of like a leaf suspension. But not much more. So I actually do have to screw this down a little tighter. It's obviously too, I think it's too loose. Now it doesn't bounce around so much. All right, that leaves the interior, and let's see if they're... Oh, boy, this is always a challenge trying to hold this thing. Let me move this camera down. Focus through that window. Can't zoom in any more than this. Let me brighten this light. 15 lumens. Well, you can definitely see the shifter there, and it looks good. You know, it's not like a Hot Wheels hot dog end. This one actually has a, you know, the knob up top. There's a vent there for the side passenger there. There's some molded details there in the center console. Looks okay. The seats, I don't know if they're just black. It looks like there would have been seat buckles there, those two recesses, but there actually are none. Would have been cool if they maybe put something there and painted them red. But maybe there's something else on the real truck, I'm not sure. Let's see from this angle. I think it's almost like a bench seat, almost sort of. The backrest is like a bench seat, but then the seat rests are split up. The steering wheel is quite plain, you know, there's no Suzuki logo there. That's kind of weak for a resin model. It should definitely be there. Let's get some light through the back window. Yeah, there's no instrument gauges either. A truck this old would definitely have analog gauges. You know, it's not going to be a digital screen. So there should be a decal there with the gauges. Yeah, so this is a bit of... Unfortunately, this just might be the worst YM models model I have, just based on the amount of work that was put into it, which actually isn't very much compared to other ones that they've put out in the past. Alright. Yeah, one thing I failed to mention, it looks like this is an intercooler back here. And... Hold on... So fine, you know, the lines. I wouldn't doubt if this is a piece of photo etched metal. This thing, it looks like an intercooler and maybe some glue residue there. But you can get that glue residue off with enough scraping, I think. All right, yeah, nice hinge details here, and then the locks, and then these tie down points. The tie down points. Oh, I wonder if those are separate pieces, but they're painted. They're so thin, you don't really see them before. I don't know if that's part of the resin casting. Maybe it's part of the resin casting, but they are very thin, so give them credit there. It would have been cool if they were actually separate pieces and colored a different separately so they would show up more. Alright, well, let's look at a few other things. Oh, I forgot. This little baggie they cut open here. We got the, what I'm guessing, are fog lights for the roof, or roof lights. Because, hold on, they have the little open bottom, and then these are lensed, which is nice. Look at this little lens, and it's a deep bucket behind that yellow lens. Very cool. Will they really stick onto the roof of this thing? I don't know. I mean, where else would they go other than on this? Well, it's very loose on the front one. Let me try the other one. But I'll try to put this one on the middle one and see what happens. Oh, no. Maybe it's meant to go on this vertical? No, this is very loose also. I feel like you'd be better off putting them on the second one. But yeah, they're all, oh boy, look at that. So this is interesting. I think those are physical pegs going into the back of the cabin. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to glue that in place. I don't want to see those black things there. It would have been better without the pegs, right? And just glue, so you could remove it and just have it custom like this. Like, honestly, I think I'd rather not even have this rack up here, but I'm pretty sure it's pegged into the roof, and so I can't remove it without having a bunch of black circles, see? Yeah, there must be two pegs there, if not more. Alright, let me do this off camera. So you can see the back photo of this. I'm gonna assume this is the same thing from the same website because the wheels are the same, it's just not finished. So this is a stage where it hasn't been modified with the lights tucked under. Assuming they modeled after this truck in the real life, I don't know, I couldn't. No idea. Leave it at that. Alright, so let's look at a few other K-class vehicles. So the closest thing I have to it is this, I believe it's an Aoshima branded all-plastic model of a Subaru Sambar. And then the Chinese have this thing called the Mini EV 6x6, and I think the company is called Wuling that makes it. Yeah, this, the actual model is made by X-Car Toys, if you want to look it up. Look up like X-Car Toys 6x6, and you'll probably find this online somewhere. I put a lot of license plates on my models, so I did put a Japanese plate on this. BM Creations has a Suzuki Jimny, and unfortunately they let you know through the tires. Not a fan of the printing on the tires, but it's on both sides of the tires, maybe. Maybe it's not, actually. Oh, you know what I did? On this side I reversed them, so that looks a little bit more normal. I should probably reverse them on both. This one had a weird roll cage of some sort. I think I literally clipped it off in certain spots because it was messed up. The Jimny, I don't think is classed as a K-class vehicle, but it's clearly as small. If we look at the overall length, I think it's shorter, possibly, or the same length. Maybe it is a K-class in Japan, but... let's see, and then I actually did this Hot Wheels wheel swap here, but it's definitely out of scale just because of the window height. The height of the windows is too tall, I think, to fit in well. Yeah, that's not gonna work. And then full-size pickup, we have this classic Chevy pickup truck, lifted, and this is by M2 Machines, if I recall. This is a GMC truck, I guess. Yeah, so it's M2 Machines. Boy, where to put this thing? I can see, you know, K-class trucks are small. And the reason for that, if you're unaware, is for tax breaks in Japan. A lighter truck is less taxing on the roads. You know, heavy trucks tear roads up. So, all right. Well, the lights here, I decided to put on the third bar because they actually are bottoming out against the roof, and so without any putty or anything like that, they seem to be in a pretty straight position. I did crazy glue on that rear roll cage. I didn't mess with the side mirror though, because it would probably leave a bad glue residue mark. Alright, well, it's still a nice model for sure. It, I guess by design, just doesn't have many parts to it because it's a pickup truck. And possibly it doesn't have disc brakes because the wheels are so small. And also, again, the early generations, I think, just had drum brakes. The earlier of this ninth generation. So it is what it is, but it is definitely lacking, I think, some interior details. I do think it should have had a decal for the instrument cluster and probably maybe a Suzuki S on the steering wheel. But I guess the decals were on the outside of this, which, again, not a fan of. But if you're lucky, if you hold out, I'm sure they're going to release these in other colors. Ideally, they'll just release it in this pink. I think that would be cool. But I decided not to wait. Thank you for watching again. We'll see you the next time I get another YM Models.